system thread exception not handled in Windows 10. That's a nasty error. How to fix it? We're gonna show you right now. Hey guys and girls, welcome back. My name is Michael and this is the official YouTube channel of Recoverit, a fully-fledged professional data recovery solution which often helps you to quickly and effectively recover accidentally lost or deleted files from pretty much any kind of storage. Today we have one more trouble to fight, and that's again related to Windows 10, a solution of the system thread exception not handled error, something which very often appears in the form of a blue screen with various error codes. Unfortunately, troubleshooting this is rather tricky, and while in most of the situations it could be triggered by a problematic video display driver, there could be a lot of other factors which are contributing to getting this blue screen, like corrupt files or problematic file system, and many, many others. Therefore, when it comes to applying solutions, there could be a combination or a number of fixes that you need to follow in order to get rid of this problem. So, jumping straight to solution number one, and this is where we would like to update the display drivers. Easiest way to launch the device manager in Windows 10: press Windows button and X on the keyboard and it's going to appear. Then expand the Display Drivers option, right-click on the primary display drivers and select Update Drivers Software. On the next prompt, select Search automatically for updated driver software and wait for a few seconds until the new drivers get downloaded and installed. Hopefully that's going to be a permanent fix to your trouble. Driver updates are always a good idea, but not necessarily the reason for such a blue screen to occur. Therefore, we're going to continue troubleshooting. For the next step, we are going to involve command prompt. So make sure to run the Windows command prompt in administrator mode. What we want to do here is to check and repair the faulty system files. So once the command prompt appears, type sfc/scannow and hit the enter button. The SFC command will start looking for damaged and corrupt system files automatically and replace them to restore your system's functionality. Once the process completes, try to stress your computer and find out whether the blue screen is going to reoccur. Okay, drivers check, system files check. Now we would like to focus on another component which can very often be the reason for multiple blue screens, including the mentioned one. We're going to test the memory. We open the run window and call the MD scheduler. This actually is the memory diagnostics tool and it's going to appear on the screen. Here we click restart now and check for problems and let the system automatically diagnose the memory. Now, if the memory is fine, it means that most likely the hardware and the operating systems are okay. So now we start chasing ghosts. No, I'm kidding. We can be more specific and therefore we're gonna restart in safe mode to figure out whether we get the blue screen in safe mode. And if we don't, then we could be certain it's more like a third-party software issue. So what we do here? First of all, press and hold the Shift button of the keyboard and tap the Restart button inside the Power menu. Then go to Troubleshoot, Advanced Option, tap Startup Settings and again select Restart. Now, by pressing the F4 key on the keyboard, we can let the system automatically boot into safe mode. Now, the next thing we should do is to try to use our computer as normal in safe mode and stress it a little bit. So if the blue screen does no longer appear, it means that we need to check the programs and features section because it clearly is something related to a third-party software. Do you know what I associate frequent blue screens with? Well, I very often associate it with corrupt files or missing data. Yes, this can very often happen because the hard drives sometimes don't have the chance to properly write the information down. And that's where we are going this time, to show you a bonus tip and trick of how to recover accidentally deleted or corrupted files. We're gonna use Wondershare's Recoverit. First of all, download and install and then start the app. On the home screen, select the location from where the files were lost during the crash. Most likely that's going to be the C drive. Recoverit is going to run a detailed scan on the hard drive and display the deleted files on the screen. After the scan completes, browse through the results and select the files that you want to restore. Finally, click Recover at the bottom right-hand corner of the screen and choose the location where you want the files to be exported. So there we go, Windows system thread exception not handled error, check. Hopefully checkmate, so that you don't really ever get this nasty blue screen again and all the surrounding troubles. And I really hope that all these ideas that we have shared with you today are easy to implement and also helped you to recover your condition. And if you know more tips and tricks, please add them in the comment section below the video. As usual, thank you very much for being with me today. For more practical data recovery solutions, subscribe to the channel. I'm Michael. Look forward to seeing you in the next video. Bye!